In the quiet of the evening, the passenger tank draws forward to take the 6:28 p.m. local to Manchester Exchange, whilst the last Deansgate trip wagons are disposed of. In the shed, renowned class 1971 Euryalus is turned in readiness for the ex Lime Street empty stock. More engine moves are required as both the rammed bottom 040 and the released coal tank retire to the steam shed. Thank you. somewhat fallen in grandeur these days, Euryalus is eventually released after the lesser engines have finished their more mundane tasks. At 18:40, the Cheshire Line's Wigan Central Local arrives into Platform 4. It needs to complete its run-round fairly smartly to avoid congestion and clear the road for the Plodder Lane goods, due in at 12 minutes past 7. road clear and the Plodder Lane goods arrives on time, appropriately hauled by a humble coal engine. Three minutes later, the last Wigan local of the day departs. The signal comes off and the 7:28 Manchester draws in. Meanwhile, the Plodder Lane train is drawn into the yard. It brings goods and coal for Crook Street Yard. The robust little coal engine was Francis Webb's first wholly independent design for the LNWR, and were very simple machines. Critics might say crude, however, they were cheap to build and could take the hard handling the LNW schedules sometimes demanded. They were extremely successful, and almost 1,000 were eventually built. Crew built one of them in 25 hours, perhaps to prove a point. With empties to remove and the clodder lane fulls to be disposed of, the yard is very busy and the shunter is hard at it. In the background, the 8:30 Kenyon Junction motor train departs. Work carries on apace in the yard. Full coal wagons are deposited in the coal yard, ready for tomorrow's coal men whilst the 8:40 Manchester local bustles past. Gas lights are winking on now, and the empties are being shunted as the 9:28 Manchester local arrives. This train has a very quick turnaround and is rarely on time. It's the last Manchester local of the day, although they run until 11 on Saturdays, and returns there via Atherton and Tilsley. In the evening lull, the coal engine is stabled in the shed, but kept in steam, its next duty being at 2:30 in the morning. The passenger tank is now released. And retires to the shed as well. ...9:36 and still the Kenyon Junction service is running. This also has a quick turnaround, leaving at 10:08. The nighttime freights arrive, the first being the Edge Hill through goods. This one comprises vans, the first four being vacuum braked, so it could have run as a Maltese, a class of express freight denoted in the working timetable by a Maltese cross and carrying a different head code and block bell code. However, it's running as a more humble and slower through goods. At last, in the now quiet station, the last passenger of the day arrives, the 10:50 from Kenyon Junction. And so ends another day at Crook Street. The goods trains, however, work through the night. But for the station staff at least, it's time for a swift one in the railway, and maybe a bag of chips from Randall's on the way home.